This zygote will develop into an entire individual. So this kind of formation of gametes, fusion of gametes and formation of zygote develops into an entire individual. All these things takes place in the sexual reproduction. And sexual reproduction, in the sexual reproduction, two parents are participating. Whereas in the asexual reproduction, how many parents are participating? Only one parent. That is why asexual reproduction is called as uniparental reproduction. Whereas in the sexual reproduction, how many parents are participating? Two parents, male and female. So this is called as biparental mode of reproduction. So these are the different types of reproductions exhibited by the living organisms. Okay, so this is character of the living organisms. Next thing is homeostasis. Homeostasis. So here, homeostasis is nothing but the maintenance of relatively constant internal environment is called as homeostasis. See, generally in the homeostasis, all the living individuals, they have body fluid, and this body fluids maintains constancy in their concentration. For example, sodium, potassium, carbonates, chlorides, some of the proteins, means all these things concentration in the body fluid should be maintained constantly. See, means by living in spite of environmental conditions, the organisms maintains a constant internal environment. That is called as dynamic constancy of internal body fluid. So all the living organisms maintains constancy of body fluid concentration. So this is one of the important characters of the living organisms. Let's see evolution. Sir, here if you look at the evolution, see here, as per evolution theories, generally life is not static. Life is not static. Means life is not constant. Life undergoes so many changes. As environment is changing, the different types of organisms get adaptations to the changing environment. So this is one kind of thing happens in the evolution. So here, as well as when the environment is changing, they get variations and also they undergo some mutations. Sir, here when the environment is changing, if the organism is not changed, it will not survive. For example, if you take Charles Darwin theory, so as per Charles Darwin theory, that is natural selection theory, survival of fittest, those organisms are fit, can be selected by the nature. The organisms without fit, they are not selected by the nature, they will be eliminated. Means when the environment is constantly changing, the animals or the organisms should get variations. Sir, these variations should be beneficial. Variation should be beneficial means the changes which are coming in the organism should be beneficial. So otherwise, if these variations or changes are not beneficial, the organism will not live. So beneficial variations will make the organism fit. And these beneficial variations accumulates over different generations. Accumulates over number of generations, that leads to the formation of new species. So that is a evolution. Means each and every living organism is not constant. It undergoes the changes. Life is not static. It is not constant. It undergoes the changes. So if you look at the evolutionary process, all the organisms evolved only due to the variations, mutations to live. Okay, so this is evolution. So generally, evolution, it starts from different single-celled organisms and it continuously occurs in the individuals on the earth. So it is a continuous process. Evolution is a continuous process. It will not stop with the men. It will not stop with the human beings. So as per evolution theories, there may be a new species from the human beings. As evolution is a continuous process, it is not static. So as the environment is changing, the individual should get adaptations, or individual should get variations or mutations. These variations and mutations accumulated over some generations, then it leads to the formation of new species. So if the species wants to survive on the earth, they should be fit.